Back in the saddle again.
Back in. Boy, that's a very appropriate thing for Mercury going into Sagittarius.
Is that what's happening this week?
Yeah, Mercury has changed signs, which is kind of a nice thing. Mercury is where your conscious mind is focused. It's left the sign of Scorpio and gone into Sagittarius, which I think is a very liberating kind of a sign.
So what does that mean for us for the next few days?
That's what I was going to talk about. For Scorpios, because it's in there for 3 weeks. For Scorpios, they want to launch a project to make more money. That's their big objective. And they can use their words rather than their back to make more money. This is the type of thing where they want to use their brains, not their back, and they'll get that opportunity to do that. And they're going to need you because they're spending money like it's going out of style.
Uh-huh.
For Sagittarians, Mercury and Mars are both in their signs, firing them up, making them take on new projects. It's like whatever went on last month, they've wiped the slate clean, and they're done with it, and they are ready to move forward again.
Okay.
So that's a pretty good thing, and it also usually means their health improves, too.
Oh, good.
That they're not keeping stuff locked up and locked inside, which is sets up the thing for dis-ease. So new starts for Sagittarians, which is a pretty cool thing. For Capricorns, this is the end of their solar year. They're the humbugs of the zodiac, and they are not going to be as forthcoming and as out in front as those Sagittarians are. This is a good time for Capricorns to finish up 2 years' worth of activity and bring that to a conclusion rather than starting new stuff. They'll get that opportunity next month. For Aquarians, this is the time to reach for the brass ring, and through the help of their friends, their group, a team effort rather than an individual effort. And Aquarians are normally pretty farsighted to start out with, but this time they're not looking at the immediate. They're looking at something 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, a year to put into work. And like I said, that's going to take a group effort. For Pisces, they are in the professional spotlight for one reason or another. And this is not a good place for Pisces to be, to tell you the truth. This is the type of thing where Pisces can get caught up in other stuff going on professionally, and they just need to keep their heads down, focus on doing their job, and not go to any fights they aren't expressly invited to attend.
Uh-oh.
For Aries, they need to hit the road. They've got important legal, educational, travel matters. Aries are trying very, very hard to take an idea and have it reach the widest audience possible, because the ninth house is long-distance kind of stuff, not just small stuff, so they'll be traveling, and it's a good time for Aries to make any kind of negotiations because they have the upper hand. For Tauruses, they are busy doing things that are going to maximize existing resources and dealing with other people's money. So, and I think it's so cute because what Pat's doing with Christmas
is
getting other people to share their resources and pool other resources together for a good outcome. So this is not about the Taurus. This is about making other people's resources grow.
Okay.
So that's the kind of good for your soul thing.
Yes, it is.
For Geminis, they are going to be in the public eye for one reason or another. Mercury is opposing their sign, and they're going to find almost every idea that they put forth being challenged, which is, and it's not a bad thing. It's just a matter of they can't. Geminis talk, and they have to realize that in the next 3 weeks or so, people will be listening, writing down what they said, and calling them to task. So, and partners have a lot to say, and Gemini should just say, yes, sir, yes, ma'am. For Cancers, their workload is about to increase dramatically. Cancers have said, you know, I'd like to do this, 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 and this, and the universe over the next 3 weeks is going to go, okay, job's yours, put your money where your mouth is. So they're likely to run out of candle before they run out of things to do. For Leos, they are going to have the best time. This is a very, very wonderfully creative time for Leo. This is one of their favorite times of year. And they get to take children of their mind, ideas they give birth to over the next 3 weeks or so, and flesh those out, and actually at the end of that 3 week period create a new child of their mind that can be very fulfilling for them.
Ooh, good.
You know, something that they've kind of thought about for 2 or 3 years finally starts to take form and go forward. So, and
that's a good thing.
Other kind of children too, so if you're of that ilk, be careful with that too. For who's left? Oh, for Virgos, they need to deal with matters at home. Virgos have been all over the place over the last 6 weeks or so. Places to go, people to see, things to do. Not anymore. They're going to start to spend the next 3 weeks organizing their home, getting their home ready, clearing it out, getting rid of debris, sticking kind of close to home to finish up projects rather than start new ones.
Okay.
And then for Libras, the last sign of the zodiac, they are all over the place. Travel, short distance travel, out and back, short distance trips. And Libras everywhere can nail down a pretty good deal for themselves. They actually have some leverage for a change in the negotiating stand. So I think it's a pretty good time for Libras to write a better contract for themselves, shake out a better deal, come to terms, meet somebody halfway, and actually close that deal in the next 3 weeks. So I don't think any of that news is bad. I think that's all good news for
pretty good to me.
A whole bunch of us. So I'm kind of glad to be able to say that's tomorrow's news today.
And that's tomorrow's good news today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I got to say one thing, man. The Lightning were amazing last night.
Oh, yeah.
It was so great to see them scoring and defending and taking shots on goal, and it was as exciting as it was looking.
In the cup year,
so welcome back, guys. Good to be back.
Yep, and we'll have you back next Wednesday. We'll do this all
next
over again.
Next Wednesday, before Thanksgiving.
Ooh, yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
All right.